Good morning, students. Now today we are going to learn about the transcription. First of all, what we should know that what is transcription? So it is the copying of the genetic information from DNA to the RNA. Okay? Or you can say that the synthesis of RNA from DNA. This process is called the transcription. Transcription is the process in which the genetic information from DNA is transferred into the RNA. There are three types of RNA, that is the messenger RNA, ribosomal RNA and transfer RNA. Messenger RNA carries the information from the DNA to the ribosome for the synthesis of proteins or enzymes. In the transcription, one of the strands acts as the template. Okay, so genetic information transfer from DNA of one strand to the RNA. So one strand acts as the template in the transcription process. Second thing is that in replication, what we studied that once the replication started, the whole DNA is replicated. But in the transcription, a segment of DNA transcribed at a time, because the different cells requires the different kinds of enzymes and different types of proteins in different time. That's why a segment of DNA is transcribed at a time. So there should be a defined boundaries. There should be the defined boundary for that segment, for that segments which are to be transcribed. So a transcription segment consists of a unit. So there are many units in the DNA which are to be transcribed, and that unit is called the transcription units. Now, first of all, one question we should know, that why the both a strand of DNA not acts as the template for the synthesis of RNA. Actually, if both strands acts as the template, then the two strands of RNA would be synthesized simultaneously, and the two strands of RNA would be complementary to each other, and they are joined together to form a double-stranded RNA. So that double-stranded RNA would not be translated into protein. First thing. Second thing is that if suppose the both strands are functional, so at the same time from the same segment of the DNA, two kinds of proteins would be synthesized having the different sequence of amino acids. So in that condition, the genetic transfer machinery would be disturbed. So that's why one of the strands acts as the template. So now we will talk that which strand acts as template. So the strands having polarity 3 prime to 5 prime acts as the template, because the transcription always occurs from 5 prime to 3 prime direction, like replication also. So replication, transcription and translation, all these three events occurs from 5 prime to 3 prime direction, because the new nucleotides always added at the 3 prime end. So that's why the transcription would be always from 5 prime to 3 prime direction. So there are the two strands in the DNA. One has the polarity 3 prime to 5 prime. Another has the polarity 5 prime to 3 prime. So this strand having the polarity 3 prime to 5 prime acts as the template for the synthesis of RNA strand. While the another strand having the polarity 5 prime to 3 prime, this strand is displaced during the process of transcription. So this strand, that polarity 3 to 5, is called the template strand, while the another strand having the polarity 5 to 3 is called the coding strand. This is the convention to say the template and coding strand. So now, first of all, this transcription process occurs all the time, and the different segments of DNA are transcribed in the different time. Now, a transcription unit, this is a unit that defines the boundary of a transcription unit. It consists of three components, that is the promoter region in the DNA, and the terminator region, and the structural gene. Means at the one end of the transcription unit, there will be a promoter region, while at the another end there is a terminator region. So this promoter and terminator defines the boundary of this transcription unit, and between this promoter and terminator there is the structural gene. The structural gene are take part in transcription. These are the genes which are to be transcribed. So at the a structural gene. Now, what is the function of this promoter? The promoter region provides the site for the attachment of RNA polymerase enzyme. RNA polymerase enzyme is responsible for the polymerization of this transcription reaction. Like in replication, there is the DNA polymerase, while in the transcription, the RNA polymerase now take part in the polymerization of this reaction. So this promoter region provides the site for the attachment of RNA polymerase, and when the RNA polymerase now attaches with the template strand at the promoter region, now it starts or initiate the process of transcription. The structural gene, these are the genes which are to be transcribed into the protein or enzyme. So these are the structural genes. And now at the end of this transcription unit, there is the terminator region. And when the RNA polymerase reaches to the terminator region, now the RNA polymerase is separated, and the newly formed RNA strand would be also separated. Conventionally, that it is said that the promoter is located at the 5 prime end. So, what we should learn here, actually, to define a transcription unit, we use the reference from the coding strand. So, coding strand means if we say that the promoter is situated or located at 5 prime end, means we should know what the 5 prime end of coding strand, while this strand do not take part in transcription, but conventionally it is used to give the reference to define the transcription unit on the basis of coding strand, and that's why it is said that the promoter is located at the 5 prime end. So whose 5 prime end? So coding strand. Likewise, terminator is located at the 3 prime end, means the whose strand? The coding strand. So because conventionally this coding strand is used to give the reference for the location of the promoter and terminator in a transcription unit, while this coding strand does not code for the protein, because it do not take part in this transcription process. It is displaced during the transcription, but to define the position of promoter terminator, we use the coding strand for the reference. Means the promoter is located at the 5 prime end of coding strand, and terminator is present at the 3 prime end of the coding strand, and this is the structural gene which the structural genes are to be transcribed. So this is the transcriptional unit that defines the boundary of the segment of DNA that is to be transcribed. Thank you.